Hey ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to talk about one of Britain's most iconic tanks who served during the Second World War, and its name is the Matilda 2 or the Matilda Senior. But before we get into the video, I'd like to set an optimistic goal of 500 subscribers at the end of the month. I know it's a lot and it is an optimistic goal, but looking at our growth, I think we can make it. Now let's get right to the video. The Matilda was designed back in 1936, and by 1939 they only had two tanks ready for combat, and the production went on until 1943. In total there were just under 3,000 tanks produced by mainly Vulcan Foundry and others. It was replaced in the frontline service by a lighter and less costly Valentine beginning in late 1941. The Matilda 2 remained in service until 1945 and even served in the 1949 Arab-Israeli War. The Matilda 2 weighed about 27 tons, which is about as heavy as the German Nassau tank, which weighed 25 tons, and a Stark 3 and a Stark 4, which both weighed around 23 tons. For a tank its time, it was very heavily armored, which made it a very good infantry support tank. Its front glacis was 78mm thick. The nose plates top and bottom were thinner but angled. The sides and hull were 65mm to 70mm thick, and the rear armor protecting the engine was about 55mm thick. Because of its heavy armor, Hitler started to worry about the tanks not being enough. This eventually is also part of the reason why he became so involved in the production of future tanks, because he was amazed of seeing how effective their thick armor was. The heavy armor of the Matilda's cast turret became legendary for a time in 1940 to 1941. For its thick armor, the Matilda got its nickname Queen of the Desert. The Matilda had an operational range of about 80 kilometers, and when you include the auxiliary tank, it is about 157 kilometers, which in my opinion is below average. Its top speed was 24 kilometers an hour, which is very slow for a tank, but it's justifiable with its horsepower to ton ratio, which set at 7.5 for each ton. But in Africa it was even slower, it could only muster an average of 9.5 kilometers an hour. Although the engine was later upgraded to a Leyland, increasing its top speed and endurance. The slow top speed of the Matilda was further exacerbated by the troublesome suspension and a comparatively weak power unit. This arrangement was complicated and time-consuming to maintain, as it required mechanics to work on each engine separately and subjected the automotive components to uneven wear and tear, which was created from two AEC six-cylinder bus engines linked to a single shaft. Its main armament was a QF 2-pounder, or 40mm gun, with 93 armor-piercing rounds. The reason why I stated this armor-piercing rounds is because the tanks were never really handed any high-explosive shells, because there was a shortage on high-explosive shells for the main gun, meaning that the tank had to heavily rely on his machine gun when operating with infantry units. Speaking about machine guns, the Matilda used the 7.92 Bessa machine guns, which almost had 3,000 rounds. Now we come to the fun part, service history. The Battle of France. The Matilda was first used in combat by the 7th Royal Tank Regiment of France in 1940. Only 23 of these units' tanks were Matilda 2s. The rest of the British infantry tanks in France were smaller machine guns armed A-11 Matildas. Its 2-pounder gun was comparable to other tank guns in the 37 to 45mm range. Due to the armor thickness, it was largely immune but not impervious to the guns of the German tanks and anti-tank guns in France. The Germans found that the 88mm anti-aircraft guns were the only effective countermeasure. The Matildas were also able to briefly disrupt the advance of the Germans, but being unsupported they sustained heavy losses. A total of 30 tanks were destroyed after the breakthrough through the rear of the Ghost Division. But after the 88mm Flak came in support, they withdrew. Up to early 1942, in the war in North Africa, the Matilda proved highly effective against Italian and German tanks, although vulnerable to larger caliber and medium caliber anti-tank guns. In late 1940, Matilda cast havoc among the Italian forces in Egypt. The Italians were equipped with L3 tankettes and M11/39 medium tanks. Neither of these stood a chance against the Matildas. As the German army received new tanks with more powerful guns, as well as more powerful anti-tank guns and ammunition, the Matilda proved less and less effective. Firing tests conducted by the Afrika Korps showed that the Matilda had become vulnerable to a number of German weapons at ordinary ranges. With the arrival of the Valentine in autumn 1941, the Matilda was phased out by the British army through attrition, with lost vehicles no longer being replaced. The Red Army received 918 of the 1,084 Matildas sent to the USSR. The Soviet Matildas saw action as early as the Battle of Moscow and became fairly common during 1942. Unsurprisingly, the tank was found to be too slow and unreliable. Crews often complained that the snow and dirt were accumulating behind the skirt panels, clogging the suspension. The Soviets modified the tanks with an addition of sections of steel welded to the tracks to give a better grip, and sometimes gave it a main armament upgrade to the ZES-5 76mm. Most Soviet Matildas were expanded during 1942, but a few served on as late as 1944. The Matilda 2s were also supplied to Australia and New Zealand in 1942 until 1944. 409 to Australia and 33 to New Zealand, as New Zealand made the decision to only use close support Valentine tanks in the Pacific theater. To minimize supply problems in the Yuan Peninsula campaign in October 1943, Matilda 2s remained in action until the last day of the war in the Wewak, Bougainville and Borneo campaigns, which made the Matilda 2 the only British tank to remain in service throughout the entire war. The tanks were often employed in the dense jungle with limited visibility and could be subject to point-blank fire from hidden Japanese artillery pieces. But the Matilda's heavy armor proved to be reasonably effective protection against this. It was armed with a QF 3-inch howitzer because it was preferred by the Australians and more effective against the Japanese bunkers. Local modifications to the tanks included improving the waterproofing and adding an outside infantry phone so supporting troops could more easily communicate with the tank crew. Guards were fitted to the suspension to stop it from being tangled with the jungle undergrowth, and the metal panels fitted to make it harder for Japanese soldiers to attach adhesive demolition charges to the hull. They also made a Matilda Frog version where they replaced the main armament with a flamethrower, and it saw some success against the Japanese in Borneo. Anyway guys, that was it for today. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you liked it, please consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll see you all in the next video.